So, as Peter said, my name is Ani Bichaku. I am a freelancer in Austrian Institute of Technology, where I'm doing my master thesis. And the part of my master thesis is building an open source cloud, which is OpenStack. My master thesis is part of the project Secure Cloud Computing for Critical Infrastructure IT. OpenStack is an open source cloud operating system. With OpenStack we can build public and private clouds. More than 18,000 members are today using OpenStack, and it's developed in more than 140 countries in all around the world. OpenStack is a collection of open source technologies. We are using OpenStack for a research of assurance in cloud environment. So we want to monitor the cloud infrastructure. For this, we have built it in Austrian Institute of Technology, a testbed with OpenStack. And we want, in the end, we want to investigate the open source monitoring tools. This open source monitoring tools has to monitor the assurance. And the goal of my thesis, in the end, will be to harmonize the different monitoring tools. With OpenStack, like with all the other clouds, we can have virtual servers, virtual network, and virtual data centers. It can have scalable servers, load balancing, which is one of the OpenStack services, virtual storage, building. Also, with OpenStack, it's possible to migrate data and applications from one machine to another in real time. OpenStack is used for disaster recovery. Three are the principles of OpenStack. Open development, open design, and open community. The code for OpenStack is freely available under the Apache 2.0. And every six months, OpenStack, the community of OpenStack holds a design summit where everyone can participate and can give the requirements for new services. For the developers, the main problem of developers by writing more and more applications is always the resources. So they need more hardware, more RAM, more CPU. That's why it's above the hardware layer, it's the virtualization. We have the virtualization layer. But with this virtualization layer, by adding more and more data centers, it's very difficult to manage them. That's why above the hypervisor layer, we have OpenStack, which will collect all these data centers in one single point. And this single point, which is OpenStack, we have compute service, network service, and storage service. The user in OpenStack has the possibility to access all these services with a dashboard. Here's some history for OpenStack. The first release of OpenStack was on 21st of October 2010, and it was called Austin. Rackspace and NASA were the first who released OpenStack. During these years, we had 9 other more releases, and the latest one is called Juno, which was released on 16th of October 2014. In our testbed, actually, it's running Ice House, because it was the latest release when we implemented our testbed. The main components of OpenStack are identity service, network service, compute service, image service, and the dashboard. As you see in the slide, each service has a code name. So the identity service in OpenStack is called Keystone. The network service is called Neutron. Compute service is called Nova. Image service Glance, and the dashboard is called Horizon. Keystone is the authentication for all the services. So to have this authentication, each service should go first from Keystone. Neutron will provide the network for the services, except for Nova, and the Nova compute is connected with Glance to store the images. The dashboard is the user interface of OpenStack. In this slide, it's the architecture, how the services are connected with each other, and how they communicate. Identity service, Keystone, provides the authorization for all the other services. Neutron, which is the network service, provides the network connectivity for the virtual machines. Compute, which is called Nova, will store the images in Glance, which is the image service. And compute also can take from Cinder, which is block storage, and provide volumes for Nova. All these disks can be stored in an object storage service, which is called Swift. And all the services and the user can access everything from the dashboard, which is called Horizon. All the services in OpenStack has MySQL database because they store users, passwords, endpoints, and roles. And they communicate with each other via RabbitMQ, which is an advanced message protocol. These are some optional services of OpenStack: Heat, which is the orchestration service, load balancing as a service, Silometer, which is a telemetry service, and Trove database as a service. Actually, in our testbed, it's running Heat, load balancing as a service, and Silometer. We didn't install Trove because in the release of Icehouse OpenStack, the Trove didn't communicate with Neutron. But it's another way to install it with Nova network, and it's possible. In this slide, we have the architecture how our testbed is built. We have 5 machines. 4 of them are used for OpenStack, and 1 is the gateway server. We have controller node 1, controller node 2, compute node 1, and compute node 2, which are the same. In the controller, the architecture has 3 networks. One is the red one, which is the administration network. The green one is the tunneling network, and the blue one is the public network for virtual machines. The blue network is without IP because OpenStack gives to the virtual machines, it will associate floating IP. That's why it should be unnumbered. And the gateway server, which is the main access with outside world for our testbed. In controller node 1, which is the main server, are installed services Keystone, Glance, Nova, Cinder, Heat, and Silometer. In the network controller, which is the controller node 2, we have Neutron, Horizon, and load balancing as a service. In compute node 1 and compute node 2, we have Nova Compute, Nova Neutron Compute, and Silometer Agent. From the OpenStack documentation, they recommend to install Horizon in the controller node 1. But for security reasons, we moved it from controller node 1 and we have it in the controller node 2. So controller node 1 will not be outside in the internet. The minimum technical requirements to build an OpenStack server if you want to have it with separated services, because OpenStack has the possibility to have it in all in one. So at least we need 3 server machines, and the CPU should support hypervisor KVM, 4 GB RAM, and 100 GB of hard drive. The operating system is recommended to be Ubuntu 14.04, 64-bit. And for the network configuration, are necessary gigabit network interface cards. This is the first impact with Horizon, so the dashboard of OpenStack. To access it, you need a username and a password. First, I want to explain to you how the virtual machine will go from OpenStack out to the outside world. First, the virtual machine is attached to a tenant network and then from this tenant network it will be connected to the tunneling network. From the tunneling network it will pass to the virtual network, which is inside OpenStack, and virtual network is connected with a virtual router to the external virtual network. The external virtual network is connected with the external unnumbered network that was with blue line in the architecture. And from there, it will go to the external switch and to external router, and it will pass outside the internet. The external network provides external internet access for the instances. The tenant network provides internal network access for the virtual machines. The virtual router will connect both networks, the virtual network and the external virtual network, and will pass the traffic from them. And to enable internet access to individual instances, they need floating IP from OpenStack. And this is a part of OpenStack that will always allocate a floating IP to each virtual machine. So how we can create the network inside the dashboard? First, we have to create the external network, which will be the external network only for OpenStack. This external network also needs a subnet attached to it. Then we have to create the tenant network, which will have a subnet attached to it as well. To connect these networks together, we will need to build a virtual router. And this virtual router will have two interfaces. One interface will be connected to the external virtual network, and one will be connected to the tenant virtual network. So how the user will create the first VM? First of all, the user should have access on Horizon or in a command line. So after the user will specify the parameters for his virtual machine, so it will be flavor, image, or key, and then the Horizon will communicate directly with Keystone to take a proof for the endpoint. The endpoint, after it will give back the access, Horizon can communicate then with Nova API. Nova API will pass the information to endpoint and to update the token that Keystone took in the beginning, and it can update this information to the scheduler and in the Nova database. The scheduler has the possibility to communicate with Nova Compute for finding a place where this virtual machine will live, and then the hypervisor will communicate with the database to update the information. The hypervisor also has to communicate with Glance, which was the image service, and to verify the ID that the user wants to build. In the end, Nova Compute should also communicate with Neutron, that was the network service, and has to assign this virtual machine to a network. Now the client has the possibility to access a new virtual machine from Horizon or from command line. To create an instance, the user needs to associate a name, a flavor, which are tiny, small, medium, large, and extra large. These are just containers. They have inside the space, memory, and the CPU. Then it has to find a boot source, which can be an image, a snapshot, or a volume. To this image, the user should associate a key pair and should assign it to a specific network. As we see in the example, we have Ubuntu 14.04 running in this network, and it has an IP given from the tenant network. This IP is only for internal use, because outside the world, the external network will associate a floating IP to this virtual machine, and we can access it only from that virtual floating IP. Also, in the dashboard, we can have a console for our virtual machines. Here we have a network topology, how it will look like if we will have more networks and more virtual machines running. As we can see, a router can have only one network, or more than one network can be connected to the same router. After we build it OpenStack, we are investigating open source monitoring tools which can monitor assurance in critical infrastructure. And for the moment, we are investigating Nagios, Moonin, Dargos, Zabbix, Sensu, Zenos, Hyperic IQ, and Cacti. We will use these monitoring tools to harmonize them so it will be possible to monitor assurance. For assurance, we have defined three classes, and for these classes, which are confidentiality, availability, and integrity, we have taken some properties for each class based on security catalogs, and we want to monitor them in terms of assurance. So everyone can get involved in OpenStack. These are the website, mailing list, and wiki. Any questions?
I have a question. Maybe I missed it, but can I do this configuration of the whole topology of machines also in some kind of description files or something like this? Because I would personally always prefer typing in a description file which I can save, which I can put into an SVN or something like this. Or is it only possible in this graphic interface?
I did this graphical interface only for the presentation because everything we did in the we did in command line.
Okay.
But as the graphical interface is very friendly, that's why I use them as screenshots for the presentation.
I see.
But it has a command line and it's more it's more easy to build it in command line. You see everything, what is installed and how it is installed.
Thank you.
I think
we have a little break, 10 minutes, after the next.